2003, Dave Riggs filmed the tagging of a 9-foot great white shark off the coast of Australia. Only months later, it was eaten alive by something much bigger.
To have a 9-foot healthy female shark eaten alive straight up set this scene of, it's a murder mystery.
Dave is searching for evidence of an enormous predator that he believes may lurk in a deep canyon below an area he calls the kill zone. Now, a new lead may offer vital evidence for his investigation.
Good to meet you, Kurt.
Yeah, good to meet you.
Absolutely.
Kurt Jenner is a principal investigator at the Centre for Whale Research in Western Australia. He's been studying whale populations for almost 30 years, but has never seen anything like this.
This is the largest bite out of anything I've ever seen in my life.
That's unbelievable.
Although it looks to have been healed for a number of years, the photo appears to show a huge bite mark close to the tail of the pygmy blue whale. They may be called pygmies, but this cousin of the blue whale can grow almost as large, reaching 80 feet in length. But what could do so much damage to one of the ocean's largest inhabitants?
Looking at how much power it would have taken to actually cut through that muscle and blubber, it must have been something like a shark.
Is there anything else that might have done this? Could it have been a propeller strike, for instance?
No, we looked at it from a number of different perspectives, and you can actually see some small teeth rake marks around it.
Could this be a shark's calling card? Great whites have multiple rows of teeth, and as one cuts through flesh, the others leave small rake marks.
The interesting thing about it as well is that that bite, to me, doesn't look like it represents the full diameter of the shark's jaws.
You're saying that's potentially just the front of the jaw, a massive shark's jaw.
By counting pixels in the image, Kurt estimates a bite radius almost 5 feet across. If this is a shark bite, the owner of these jaws would be a staggering size. And if it were a great white, it would be of freakish proportions, approaching the size of a whale. Dave is piecing together a profile of the killer.
Given the evidence we've collected, we could be looking at a huge shark. You're looking at somewhere around 35 feet long. I don't think there's any chance in the world it's a megalodon. They became extinct between 2 and 10 million years ago. That's gone, done and dusted. This is real. We need to get to the bottom of it.
If it is a new type of supersized shark, Dave thinks a major feeding event in the kill zone could draw it up from the canyon's depths. And if it is lured to the surface, he now plans to meet it face to face by going underwater in the kill zone for the very first time. But this requires both planning and innovation.
How are we going to safely examine this area and for no one to get hurt?
These waters are home to some of the biggest great white sharks on the planet. So Dave's gathered an expert team for the mission. No one understands the great whites here better than world-renowned expert Andrew Fox.
It's a very sharky-looking day.
Well, we've got the cloud cover, they like that. They like the dark conditions.
Professional divers Mark and Andre will pilot the machine.
Down to the right!
We just want to test the integrity of it to make sure it can stand up to a bump and a nudge from a big predator. And hopefully one's going to turn up and we'll get an idea of whether they think this is something to eat or not. Yeah, I'm a bit nervous about it.
Dave starts by towing the unmanned machine behind a small dinghy. while the rest of the team monitor its performance from a larger boat.
Pretty buoyant, isn't it?
The goal is to fine-tune the buoyancy and gauge what's known as the yummy hum. This is the level of interest it draws from animals once the electrical propulsion system is fired up. Sharks in particular are attracted by these low-frequency sounds.
So far, so good. Pretty awesome.
The submersible proves perfectly balanced at 30 feet below the surface. Now, it's time to power up the thrusters.
Looks good. That's travelling well, Andre.
After a few minutes, the team are satisfied the propulsion system is running smoothly. But the flying machine is about to get an unscheduled road test.
There's a really big shark right there.
It's a female great white, over 15 feet long.
Just sitting there, having a look. That shark looked like it wasn't too far short of this boat.
She gapes her mouth at the machine. It's a behaviour that signals a mixture of caution and curiosity. In the end, curiosity wins. If the shark latches on to the flying machine, it could capsize the towboat.
This dodgy situation.
Dave abandons the submersible, but before the team can pull it to safety, the shark decides to test whether the strange yellow object is edible.
Oh, don't bite it.
She catches the rope connecting the machine to the boat, severing it.
Did it bite it? Really? Still sinking, hey? Yeah, there's